did you find Wentworth, Doctor?
Depressing.
But then you could leave each day.
Exactly. I left for good.
I wish you hadn't.
Well, I'm sorry.
They still haven't found a replacement for you.
No, well, that doesn't surprise me.
Why is that?
Because altruism is one thing and self-immolation is quite another.
Oh, aren't you being a little melodramatic?
Yes, I suppose I am.
You wouldn't reconsider, would you?
Is that why you came here today? I mean, is that why you're here?
Yes, of course. Why else did you think?
Well, I thought... But I don't know. This really is unfair, Karen. I mean, you know how I feel about this.
Oh, I certainly do now.
Look, don't think I'm unfeeling or that I don't understand your concern.
Of course not.
I have given this a great deal of thought, I promise you.
I'm sure.
Come on, Angela, this is pointless.
But they found her. And now she's as safe as houses. Does that mean something too?
You bet your life, sweetheart. That means my boy's found the Buchanan bitch.
Don't get sucked in, old boy. All that perfume, nice legs. Believe me, she's as hard as the proverbial. Believe me, ruthless. Stop at nothing to help the downtrodden. All that bullshit nonsense.
Yes, there was perfume, and she certainly is very attractive.
Certainly that. Exceptional for a pink girl. Pity that.
What, a loss to our side, do you mean?
That too. But I was thinking of the other thing.
The other?
Oh, I mean, you know, she's gay.
Coffee's still hot.
I don't think I'll go to uni today. That is, if you don't mind.
Well, it's not up to me. I'd have thought you'd had enough of people telling you what to do. How are your studies going?
All right, I guess. I think I really only started them to get out of Wentworth. Now I'm out, there doesn't seem much point.
Well, maybe you don't need a degree for the sort of work you're going to be doing. Look, I'm going to an estate agent today. He's found a possible halfway house. Since you're free, why don't you come along? I'll meet you there at 11:30.
Oh, wait a minute. Can we afford a place yet?
Well, if we waited till we could afford it, we'd never get anything done. We'll just have to make the best with what we've got.
I don't know whether I'm too good at that.
Well, you don't know until you try.
I have tried. I didn't do very well with Greg, did I?
Oh. Is that the problem? Look, you can't get put off by one knockback. I've had so many doors slammed in my face, it's a wonder I haven't got a flat nose. That's no reason to give up. Just keep plugging away. We'll get through to him.
I wouldn't be so sure. Not as long as Meg Jackson's got a clause into him. There's no way she wants him to mix business with pleasure. She's not going to let him back into that prison.
Morning, Doc. Thought you'd had enough of this place.
So did I.
Come in. Oh, Dr. Miller. I was surprised to receive your phone call this morning. It sounded urgent.
Oh, not exactly.
Oh, please sit down. Could I get you anything? Tea? Coffee?
No, thank you. Have you found a new doctor yet?
No, not yet. You know what these things are like. It'll probably take months.
Yes, well, under the right circumstances, I'd be willing to offer my services again.
Are you sure?
Well, why not?
Well, you seemed so adamant about leaving.
Well, things didn't exactly work out as I planned. Some of the patients are a bit slow in paying.
What happens when they do start paying? Do you walk out again?
Look, if you don't want my help, then...
No, not at all. Even in the short term, it would be most welcome. When could you start?
Well, straight away. I would have to restrict my visits to a couple of days a week, and it would be on the understanding that you keep looking for a permanent replacement.
That won't be my responsibility.
No, Meg told me you'd resigned. Do you have anything definite to do?
Oh, I'm sure I'll find something in time. Having been tied to this place for so long, I'm rather looking forward to the rest.
Well, you certainly earned it. Do any of the women need to see me?
I don't think so. You could take a look at Doreen. I'm not sure her stay in the psychiatric hospital did her any good. I'd be interested to hear your opinion.
Anybody got a life? Doreen.
Thought Martha always licked your fags.
She's resting. Moni gave her a real thump in the stomach.
Oh, yeah, that's because she's so stupid she can't keep out of her own way.
She was too slow, that's all.
Well, I could have done it.
Yes? Well, you might get your chance to find out soon.
Yeah, well, I'll be ready.
You shouldn't do nothing for her.
Why not? You were pretty keen when there was some grog in it.
Yeah, well, that didn't last long. She might have plenty of pull on the outside, but she's not doing much for herself in here.
Well, she's doing better than you. Besides, you've got to stick with those who are in charge. It's no good on your own.
Who says she's in charge? We'll be out of solitary soon.
Lizzie, quit gossiping. Get on with your work. On your feet, Smith. Well, what's the matter? Don't you want to get out of here? I'm sure that could be arranged if we called the VJ back.
I never should have been in here in the first place.
Cause trouble and what do you expect?
Mrs. Davidson promised me safe conduct. It's the last time I ever believe anything a bloody screw tells me.
Well, you can believe this, Smith. Take one step out of line and you'll end up back in here for another 2 weeks. And don't expect the other women to support you. They've seen through you. They won't be following any of your orders anymore.
We'll see.
Yes, we will. There have been a few changes while you've been locked in here. Now get going. The governor wants to see you. Unless, of course, you want to stay here.
Angela Jeffries' residence.
Hello, Karen. It's Greg. Karen?
If you want to speak to Angela, she's not here.
Actually, it was you I wanted to speak to. Are you free for dinner tonight?
No, I'm busy.
Well, when are you free? We need to talk.
I think you said all you had to say yesterday.
Not exactly.
Well, I did.
Come in.
B. Smith.
Show her in.
In here, Smith.
Well, I hope you've learned your lesson. If you cause trouble, you must expect to be punished. Inciting a riot is a very serious offence.
There wouldn't have been a riot if Noeline hadn't started throwing things.
And she wouldn't have started throwing things if you hadn't goaded her into it. Surely you must admit that.
Oh, I'll admit it. After all, I don't want to be accused of lying, do I?
You were promised safe conduct as long as the women were barricaded in the dining room. Nothing was said about afterwards. In any case, Dr. Miller has agreed to come back to Wentworth without any coercion from you or anyone else. The whole episode was a waste of time.
I haven't got anything better to do.
Then you'd better find something. You can't expect the lenient treatment you received in the past to continue.
You call 2 weeks in solitary lenient?
After the trouble you caused? Yes, I do. And if the women hadn't been sensible enough to return to their cells, you would have stayed in there much longer. Take her back to the laundry, Miss Bennett. Keep an eye on her. We don't want any repercussions over what has happened.
Come on, Smith. McNally, put that magazine away and get on with your work.
Didn't anyone tell you it was rude to shout, Vera? Funny, George always said he couldn't stand loud women.
You think you're something, don't you? Well, you should get on with Smith here. She thinks she runs the place as well. No doubt you've heard of Toni McNally, Smith.
What you in for?
Mistaken identity. They say I knocked off some slut who was playing around with my old man.
There was a witness.
But they can't find her.
Can they?
Good hope, eh?
We missed you.
Get back to work, Lizzie, and that goes for the rest of you. You heard me, Anderson.
But I thought Bea was going to work the press.
Seems like she's learned her lesson.
How you been keeping, Bea?
If you'd have cared, you could have come and asked me.
Oh, the screws wouldn't let us anywhere near you. I'm sorry what happened in the dining room, Bea. But it was Nolan and money. I'd have stuck by you, but what could I do on me own?
Yeah, I don't blame you, Lizzie. Where's Molly and Nolo now?
Released.
Yeah, well, just as well for them.
Lizzie, Doreen needs some more sheets.
I'm talking to B.
Do as you're told.
See? I told you Toni was in charge.
Don't you believe it. B won't take it that easy. There's gonna be trouble.
Late?
It's all right. The estate agent's not here yet.
So, this is it.
It's what's known as a renovator's dream.
Looks more like a renovator's nightmare.
You wait till you see around the back. Any messages?
No. Oh, yeah, Greg Miller rang.
What did he want?
I don't know. I hung up on him.
But why did you do that?
What did you expect me to do after the way he carried on yesterday?
But you can't get him to change his mind if you won't talk to him. Look, if we're going to get this project off the ground, you're going to have to be polite to a lot worse than Greg Miller.
Sorry I'm late, Angela. Had a bit of bother down in Swan Street. Tenants wouldn't pay their rent. Oh, we haven't met.
Karen, how do you do?
Hi.
What happened to your tenants?
Well, I had to take out an eviction order against them. What else could I do? Well, shall we take a look inside? Haven't got a front door key. We'll have to go around the back. Great opportunity for a renovator.
See what I mean?
Make a lovely couple. I wonder how long that's going to last.
Do you think she's trying to make trouble between us?
No, she's wasting her time.
Glad to hear it. You've got enough trouble keeping the screws in line in here.
You've got enough trouble. I'm looking after number one.
Folding sheets must be a bit of a come down for you, Smith. I suppose you thought you were going to be top dog again as soon as you got out. I told you there'd been a few changes.
Looks like the same old pig pen to me, Vera.
McNally's solicitor's here to see her.
Oh, do you hear that, McNally? You've got a visitor. I'll take her along.
Shall I keep an eye on the others?
No, I'm sure they've got a lot to talk about. Leave them to it. Come on, McNally.
What do you think of that tone, B? She's got real good connections on the outside.
Yeah? Well, they can't be all that good, can they? Otherwise, she wouldn't be in here.
Toni, I'd like a word with my client in private, officer.
I'm aware of the rules, Mr. Mancini. We always stick to them in here. Bitch. Should arrange some leave for her as well.
That won't be necessary. Your trial's set for next week. You'll be out of here soon.
About time, too. What's happened to Glenys?
Oh, we're keeping an eye on her. She's made no attempt to contact the police.
Not yet.
Your husband thinks we should try and buy her off.
He would. Getting bloody soft in his old age.
He just doesn't want any more fuss.
He isn't on trial, is he? There's only one way to make sure she doesn't talk.
You mean kill her?
What the hell do you think I mean?
Sean isn't going to like it, Toni.
Then he can lump it. I've told you before, Terry. You do as I say, or I get a lawyer who will.
Let me out, Miss Bennett, please.
That didn't take long.
Well, it's a nice, simple case, isn't it?
No troubles at all.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
I'm getting Toni's dinner.
I'll get yours, B. You sit down.
I'm in no hurry to get poisoned.
Thank you.
Thanks, Doreen.
Mind if I sit here?
Sure. Make room, Doreen.
Got them all jumping, haven't you?
That's right. Didn't you when you were in charge?
Oh, yeah. But he was real tough.
And she can be again. Soon. After I get out.
You reckon you're going to get away with it, do you?
Oh, yes. My lawyer will make sure I do.
Lunch.
Oh. How did it go?
Well, he wasn't there. He was out on business.
When will he be back?
I don't know. I didn't ask. I'm not even sure what you want me to say to him.
Why don't you ask him to join the halfway house committee?
Well, if he's not going to work at the prison where he gets paid, he's hardly going to help us.
Why not? People often say yes to things they know will never happen. Once we've got him, we can put some pressure on him.
You're an awful fraud.
I am not. If you don't ask him, I will.
I'm not so sure about that house. It's a bit of a mess.
Oh, that's why it's cheap. I don't think we can do better for the money we can afford, unless we go out into the suburbs. And community reaction isn't going to be as sympathetic out there. What we need are some heavies on the committee. If we want money and help from the government, we've got to have someone from the department on side. Do you think there's anyone at Wentworth who might be sympathetic?
Well, there's Mrs. Jackson, I suppose. And the governor.
Erica. Of course. That would be a feather in our caps, having her on the committee.
Ah, oh, Miss Bennett. These are next month's rosters. Would you get them completed, please?
That's the deputy governor's job.
Well, he's not here, is he? I want everything up to date before I leave. Mr. Douglas from the department will be here in a day or so. No doubt he wishes to discuss my resignation.
You can't leave with Mr. Fletcher away. Who'll be in charge?
That will be up to Mr. Douglas. How is B. Smith settling back in?
Oh, very quietly. McNally seems to have the upper hand. She's even got Anderson waiting on her hand and foot.
Has she? Bring Doreen to me after she's finished lunch, would you, Miss Bennett?
Right.
Get me some sweets, Doreen. What are you staring at?
I don't know. The label's come off.
Watch it, Smith.
What are you going to do? Get Doreen to thump me?
No. Maybe I'll get Martha to do it.
That loony.
Who's a loony?
You are, if you keep following her around like a lame dog.
Oh, yeah, you're right one to talk. You're so stupid that you had to spend 2 weeks in solitary.
I got stuck in solitary trying to get your bloody doctor.
Sit down, Doreen. Trouble, girls?
No, Miss Bennett. Everything's fine.
Come on, Anderson. You're going to see the governor.
I didn't do nothing.
Then you've got nothing to worry about, have you? She was fighting in the dining room with Smith.
I wasn't.
I thought you said everything was quiet.
Oh, I stopped it before it got out of hand.
I see. That will be all, Miss Bennett. Sit down, Doreen. What happened?
Nothing. They just grabbed me, that's all.
Why did she do that?
I don't know.
Doreen, I understand you've been waiting on Toni McNally, fetching meals for her. Now, we all know these power struggles go on. It's inevitable with so many women locked up together. But I don't want you getting involved.
Well, what else can I do?
Well, you could start thinking about your parole. It's due quite soon. Any trouble could just extend the sentence. Have you thought about what you're going to do when you get outside? Do you have anywhere to stay, any friends or relatives?
I haven't had no visitors the whole time I've been in here.
Well, you can't be paroled unless you have somewhere to stay. You do want to be paroled.
What's the point? I've been in and out of places like this since I was a kid. I'll only end up back inside again. It's different for people like you, Mrs. Davidson. But there's nothing on the outside for me.
Hello, Karen. What can I do for you?
I wanted to apologize for snapping at you.
Oh, it's okay.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I had no right.
No, don't worry about it.
Can I change my mind, then, about dinner?
Sure. Great. Well, shall I pick you up there? What time?
Well, I'd like to meet you somewhere, if that's all right. I have to take some books back to the university library, so I thought I could go on from there.
Okay, well, how about the Dorset? That's close, and the food's terrific.
It's a bit pricey, isn't it?
Aren't you complaining already?
No, well, 7:30 then.
Okay, fine, see you there.
Bye.
Cup of tea, Gran? Gran? Gran?
Yes, dear, what is it?
What if it's the matter?
You just looked. Oh, I don't know, I was just worried.
Don't you worry about me. I'm just a bit tired, that's all.
You haven't really got over the flu yet, have you?
Oh, nonsense, dear. I'm perfectly all right.
Oh. Hello, Judy.
Mr. Jackson, come in.
Hello, Mum.
Oh, how nice to see you again.
Well, she's looking tremendous, isn't she?
Tremendous is the word.
How long is it now? What, about 2 weeks?
Yes, there's no problems at all.
That's terrific.
Sit down, Mrs. Jackson. Thank you. Not working today?
Night shift.
Oh.
Oh, I don't mind, as long as it doesn't happen too often. Actually, it gives me a chance to do my shopping. Oh, which reminds me. On sale. A real bargain.
Oh. Oh. That's great. That's just what we needed.
How much do we owe you?
Well, nothing. It's a present.
Oh, now that's
no,
very
no, really. It hardly cost a thing.
Mrs. Jackson, thanks.
Honestly.
I don't believe you, but thank you anyway.
Well... How have you been?
Fine.
I'm sick.
What?
I'm fine. I've just had a touch of...
She still gets an awful cold and she's getting headaches.
Now, Judy...
They're really bad ones, Mrs. Jackson. I try to get her to get some more rest, but she won't.
Judy, that's enough.
Well, you ought to see a doctor.
Whatever for?
Just have a checkup, Gran.
Dr. Miller's got his own practice now. It's not far from here. Why don't you go and visit him?
Really, there's nothing wrong with me except old age. Not even Dr. Miller can fix that. Stop complaining, dear, and go and put the kettle on. I'm sure Mrs. Jackson's dying for a cup of tea.
Right.
Don't take any notice of her. She's getting nervous, that's all. And as there's obviously nothing to worry about with the baby, she's taking it out on me. You say Dr. Miller's got his own practice?
Yes.
He's left Wentworth completely?
And we're finding it very difficult to get a replacement.
I can't say I blame him, but it must be hard on the girls. I remember what it was like before he came. I've tried so hard to forget that I was ever in there, and I've had every reason to, but I can't. There are too many memories.
Wasn't expecting him so soon. You'd better bring him up. Thank you.
Last.
Come in.
Mr. Douglas to see you, Mrs. Davis.
Erica, how are you, eh?
Very well, thank you. Thank you, Miss Williams. Could you arrange for some tea or coffee?
Oh, not for me, thank you.
Well, don't bother then. Do sit down, Mr. Douglas.
Oh, come now, Erica. Ted, eh?
Ted.
Now, what's this all about?
My resignation? Mm-hmm. Let's just say I don't think I am capable of governing Wentworth in the way some people think I should.
Oh, nonsense. You're one of the best people we've got. Now, you're not still fretting about this inquiry, are you? You know, there was nothing personal in that. And things had got a little out of hand.
My resignation has nothing to do with that. Under the circumstances, I don't see what else the department could have done.
Well, then what is the problem? Erica, look, we've known each other for some time now. If there's something worrying you, I want to know what it is.
Whatever I have done, whatever mistakes I have made, I have always tried to do my job with integrity.
Yes, I don't think anyone would question that.
Until recently.
Oh, I don't understand.
Ted, why has my deputy governor been granted leave when I am so short-staffed?
Well, I thought you recommended it.
I most certainly did not. I passed on his request, expecting it to be refused, which it was. Then suddenly, the decision was reversed.
Well, I'll look into it. Is that all that's worrying you?
No. Have you heard of Antonia McNally?
McNally, yes. Yes, the woman the afternoon press delight in calling the Queen of the Underworld. On remand for murder, if I remember correctly.
You do?
Yes.
Unfortunately, her influence seems to extend somewhat further than the underworld.
What are you suggesting?
I would have thought that was rather obvious.
That's a rather serious accusation, Erica. What proof do you have?
None. I know this is going to ruin my whole argument. In fact, nothing really straightforward has been said. It's all been suggestion, innuendo. I could be wrong, but I am quite sure I am not. If I had any proof, I could demand an investigation, even put a stop to it. As it is, I have no choice but to ask you to accept my resignation.
Hello, Greg.
Karen.
May I take your coat, madame?
Thank you.
Champagne now, monsieur?
Yes, thank you. You look fantastic.
Borrowed feathers. Angela's very generous.
Oh, feathers have nothing to do with it.
I didn't look so great in blue denim, did I? Sorry. Just it always makes me feel self-conscious.
Well, you have no reason to feel self-conscious. Especially with an old friend like me.
You could be the main reason.
Yes, thank you.
Champagne.
Celebration.
What are we celebrating?
Well, a number of things, really.
For instance?
Well, for a start, I saw Erica today. Told her I'd go back to the prison.
Oh, Greg!
Only for 2 days a week.
Still, that's something.
And on condition they keep looking for a replacement.
That's absolutely marvellous. I'm so pleased.
Yeah. Well, I hoped you would be.
I didn't realize you were still in the building.
Oh, I had a lot of work to get through, but it's all done now.
Betty Williams said Mr. Douglas was in today.
Yes. He tried to talk me out of my decision.
I hope he succeeded.
Partially.
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I've agreed to take some leave and reconsider my decision.
Good idea. You certainly deserve a holiday.
Oh, I don't know. We're so short-staffed here, it doesn't seem right.
Well, it's better than leaving us all together.
I suppose so, but I may never come back.
Wouldn't blame you. How long are you taking?
3 weeks.
Oh, we can certainly manage for that long.
Yes, and Dr. Miller's decision helps enormously.
Greg!
It's a tremendous relief, even though he's only coming back for 2 days a week. I can't tell you what a help it is. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize, didn't you know?
No, I didn't.
Well, I thought you'd talked him into it. Well, he did say something about financial difficulties, but how odd. I wonder what made him change his mind.
No idea.
I could eat this every day for a year and still not have enough.
Yeah, I've noticed. Mm.
It's funny. When I first got out of prison, I was so confused. I had almost no appetite at all. Now I can't seem to stop eating. I'm afraid I'm going to blow up like a balloon.
You're happy then?
I don't know. Yes, I think so. Things weren't as easy as I thought they'd be. But working with Angela has been wonderful, and the free accommodation's made a big difference.
Well, you weren't paying any board at Mrs. Witten's, were you?
Well, that's hardly the same thing, Greg. I'll introduce you to Mrs. Witten one day.
Oh, don't bother. A close friend of your mother's, I can imagine.
Well, Angela's just the opposite. And I really feel at home in that house. You know, she's a wonderful person, very sophisticated and sure of herself, yet thoughtful. Did you see that coat I had on when I came in?
Mm-hmm.
Well, she let me borrow it because she thought it'd make me feel better. And she was right, it did. Even if they did take it off me the minute I came in the door.
Don't get too dependent on her, Karen.
Sorry?
I mean, I've nothing against Angela personally, but I just don't think it's a good idea that you should get too involved with her.
In what way?
Has it occurred to you that she might be just using you?
In connection with the halfway house? Yes, probably, but I don't mind. It's an idea I've always wanted to see get off the ground, and I think Angela's the one who could do it. So if I can help, why not?
Yeah, that isn't what I meant exactly.
Well, what then?
I just didn't want to see you getting hurt, that's all.
Why should I get hurt?
Oh, no, nothing, forget it, I'm just being silly.
Greg, you really are very sweet to worry about me, but I can take care of myself.
Yeah, sure.
Thought you'd be in the rec room.
After 2 weeks in solitary, couldn't stand the noise. As a matter of fact, it's getting pretty noisy in here.
You're pretty upset about the women not supporting you over the riot, aren't you?
Wouldn't you be?
No. They're mindless. Without you there, they'd do anything any idiot told them to.
Yeah, so I've noticed.
I'm trying to be nice. All I'm saying is that there are only two kinds of animal. Followers and leaders. We're both leaders. So we can lead together, or we can work against each other. You can't beat me.
No.
Nobody ever has. I'm going to beat this rap, too. When I get out of here, we could be really useful to each other. I could get you things from outside. And it'd be useful to have a contact in here.
I'm no one's messenger.
You wouldn't have to be. I've got idiots like Martha to do that. An organization as big as mine has got girls coming in and out of here all the time. You could look after them. Make sure they're kept out of trouble.
Funny, I thought it was your husband's organization.
So did he. You know what men are. Children.
You don't have to tell me that.
But what do you say? Partners? It'd really get up Vera's nose.
Okay, you're on.
Good. Let's celebrate. These are the last two. The screw's got the rest. Mm-hmm. However, there's plenty more where these came from. To us.
To us.
Ah, the innocent returns.
Hi. How did it go?
Great.
How was the food?
Wonderful. In fact, the whole evening was wonderful. But the best news of all is that Greg's decided to go back to the prison.
Congratulations.
Well, well, well. Did he say why?
Knees and perfume.
Have I missed something?
No, it's just a silly joke. Honestly, though, Greg's a very good person. I don't think he did it just to impress me.
No, indeed. I should think he expects a little something in return.
No, Tina, Greg's not like that. He's very straight.
Uh-huh. Therein, I suspect, lies the motive.
What do you mean?
That's enough, Tina.
You mean you haven't told her?
Told me what?
What does your Dr. Miller think of Angie?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Oh, no, I don't mean nothing.
We talked about you, of course, and the PRG. He warned me against getting a bit too involved.
Oh, with whom?
Well, just generally. He thinks that after all that time inside, I must be a bit emotionally vulnerable. Well, I think he's taking the whole thing a bit too seriously.
Oh, you do, do you? God, you're naive, Karen. He's trying to save you from a fate worse than death, and you don't even know it.
What? Didn't you say you had to have an early night?
Oh, yes. How true. Night, Karen. Night, old love. Thanks for the dinner.
Would you like a drink?
No, thanks.
Tina's a very intuitive person. She's often right. She's also rather tactless.
What was all that about?
When Greg warned you about getting involved with me, he didn't mean the PRG. He meant me.
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
He was trying to tell you that I'm a homosexual. A lesbian, if you like. Oh, I don't keep it a secret. The reason we've never discussed it before, it's not been relevant.
Well, what's it got to do with Greg?
Well, I would say that Dr. Miller has interpreted my interest in you as a prelude to seduction. He hopes by winning your affections to keep you on the straight and narrow, thus protecting you from my perversions. You don't have to stay here if you don't want to, Karen.
Of course I want to stay here. How can you be so devious? So narrow-minded and totally irrational.
Who's working the press today?
Who cares? G'day, B.
No, hi.
How you going?
Gee, it makes you sick.
Sure does.
What's up with you?
Oh, bloody Toni. I nearly get me face pushed in standing up to B for her, and now they're thick as thieves.
Don't worry, love. It's better than having them fighting.
Yeah, well, if they do, they can do it on their own in future. I wouldn't help either of them.
Keep your voice down. They'll hear you.
I don't care.
You don't care? Now, you better be careful. You don't want to get on the wrong side of that McNally woman.
Morning.
Good morning.
I decided to come back. A couple of days a week, that's all.
Yes, Erica told me.
Yeah, it's not much, but best I can do.
Well, is that why? To help out?
Partly, yes. Also, I need the money. I mean, you know what my patients are like at paying.
Yes, I do. But I didn't realize you were so desperate.
Desperate?
Well, the last time you spoke to me, you weren't coming back here under any circumstances.
Impossible dream.
How's Karen? Well, you saw her the other day, didn't you?
Yes. Well, she's fine. What's that got to do with anything?
That's what I'd like to know.
Look, Meg, I know you don't like the idea, but it's only for a little while and I do need the money.
You're lying, Greg. Now, look, I don't know why you changed your mind, and I'm not even sure I want to know. But it certainly wasn't for the money.
Meg,
no, not now. You think about it. If you want to talk, give me a ring.
She back yet?
Nope. What's the word?
She gets the chop.
Right. Wait for her inside?
Yeah.
Going somewhere, are we?
Get the car.
Yes.
I reckon we can give you a lift. You're not going to disappoint us, are you, Gladys?
Ren, I told you not to carry all those. See the doctor? You promised me you would.
Oh, darling, don't nag.
Gran, look at you. You need a doctor.
Oh, don't exaggerate.
I'm not. Why are you so late? You've been working overtime again, haven't you?
We need the money.
No, we don't. Not that much. Oh, Gran, don't you see? If you keep working this hard, you'll get really sick. And then what will I do? Oh, Gran, I need you. I need you much more than the money.
Oh, don't worry, darling. I'll be all right. Truly.
Oh,